attentive presences entering my humble office. They need to release the anger and pent-up frustration from their chi. Jason and Maggie, I presume. Let's begin. How?
Doc, I want to come out and tell you, I don't think we have any problems. This wasn't my idea to come here, so with that being said, what do you think?
Jason, you know why we're here. Let's just sit and listen and see what the doctor has to say.
Thank you, Maggie. Now, as I was saying, what brings the two of you here?
Well, it's been going on for the past month or so. We can't seem to talk anymore. All we ever do is fight.
Maggie, where do you get off telling a complete stranger our problems? You're by far the most annoying woman I've ever been with.
Jason, down. Listen to yourself. You sound like a freaking crazy person.
This is terribly interesting. Now, let's begin at the beginning. How did the two of you first meet?
Doc, that's none of your business. Not only is it none of your business, I doubt I can remember back that far.
Really? How long have we been together then, Jason?
That's easy. 13 months.
Are you like positively sure about that?
Sure. What are you taking for? One of those superficial jerks that can't remember how long we've been together?
Maggie, is there something wrong?
No, I'm fine. I just need a minute. I swear, I'm going to leave you for that man that I met in the bar last night if you don't straighten up. We've been together for 15 months, for your information.
Wait, bar? You said you were at your sister's last night.
My sister and I. We went to the bar, it was no big, just grow up.
Good, let it all out, dear.
Come on, man. Did he have tattoos? Was he buffer than me? Did you talk to him? I swear if you did, I don't know what I'll do, but I promise you, you're not gonna like it.
He was very, very, very muscular. And his name was Hank, and he was very nice. Unlike someone I can think of.
Now, Maggie, why would you think that Jason is not nice?
Yeah, why?
Now, Jason, I'm the doctor. Please let me ask the questions. Maggie?
Well, we fight so much, and he never calls me, and he never takes me to the movies, and he never gets me anything, and he never gets me anything.
Boo, poo, poo. Honestly think I'm going to spend my hard-earned money on things you think you deserve.
Now, Jason, why would you think that Maggie deserves your attention and affection?
You know what, Doc? It's because she knows she can't find anybody to deal with her psychotic self.
I'm sorry for the bad behavior.
Hey, what is wrong with you? You're like a freaking one-woman circus here. You're up and you're down. You're here and you're there. You're all over the place right now. What happened to the cool Maggie? The fun Maggie? Maggie that had aspirations and just loved being with me.
So we're calling you some sort of crazy person or something.
That's not what I'm saying. Here we go again. You're always trying to turn what I say to get around at me so we can fight again.
Interesting. Terribly, terribly interesting.
You know what, Doc? We can just butt out for just 1 second. This doesn't concern you at all. Now, honey, just talk to me.
What do you want me to say? I don't have one nice thing to say to you.
You know what? What about the guy at the bar? What do you have to say about him? Are there more of them that I should know about?
So you're going to sit here and question me on one night? Why is it that you're out late 3 nights a week and you're so freaking jumpy all the time?
Now, Maggie, those are some broad assumptions that aren't relevant to the session.
For once, I have to agree with the doc. You mean to tell you why I'm so jumpy all the time? You mean to tell you why I'm always out late? I have to work to support your crazy stuff. And you know why I'm so jumpy? Because whenever I come home from working late, I have to come home such a psychotic person.
Seriously?
You heard me. Honey, what's wrong with you?
You're seeing another woman. I know you are. You don't touch or kiss me like you used to?
Honey, you'd know if I was you.
Now, Jason, let's say, hypothetically, you were cheating on Maggie.
But I'm not cheating on her.
Hypothetically, what would you say?
But I'm not cheating on her.
Jason, It's a hypothetical situation. Jason, look at me. Jason! Jason, look at me, I tell you. I can feel your chi. It's pushing away from me. Open your mind.
My mind is perfectly open.
Jason, let's say, hypothetically, you were cheating on Maggie. What would you say?
Okay, hypothetically.
Hypothetically.
Since this is a hypothetical situation,
it
right?
Is.
Okay, hypothetically, if I were cheating, I'd say something random and off the top about working at workshops and this and that. Basically, I'd be working late.
Jason.
Yeah, Doc?
Didn't you just say that the reason that you're out 3 nights a week is that you work late?
Wait. Are you saying that I really am cheating?
No! Heavens, no. I'm merely saying that when asked what you would say if you were cheating, you first replied that you would make up excuses about work, yet, when put on the spot, your first answer was that you work late.
Oh my gosh, Jason! How could you?
Sweetie.
Don't sweetie me, you pompous jerk! I can't believe that I ever trusted you! You're nothing more than a womanizing... That would not know a good thing if it hit him in the face!
Hey! Now, sweetie, let me explain here. Thanks a lot, Doc. Thanks that your overeducated mouth seems to have gotten me into
it. Oh, you're quite welcome, Jason. It is my job to point out the little things that ordinary people would notice. And why don't you take these anger management implementation devices? It's an incredibly expensive investment in anger management.
If Spider-Man bad, you can buy from Walmart.
Do I know her?
Hey!
What's her name? Is she pregnant with me? Hey, she can't be if she's with you.
It's a little below the belt.
No, so it's cheating on me!
Have you lost your mind?
No, but I'm about to.